everyone, and thank you for attending our presentation. Our project has been designed to elaborate the topic of discrimination in sports. And before we go into details, we would like to show you our logo. As you can see, our logo consists of three female students gathering behind their screens and coming together for a mission in online education. This logo represents the three of us, Chems, Nawal, and Rose, three foreign students, united for a single common mission to guarantee access to information in its digital form for students, despite the distance and the current state of health. This sequence is aimed at students with a B1 English level. It was created for a group of 30 students enrolled in L3 steps at the University of Rennes 2. However, we consider they can be easily adaptable in different domains if the linguistic objective and the subject fit the students' and the teachers' necessities. This online language game takes the students through an English learning sequence that involves the subject of discrimination in sports. During four sessions, students will learn in a very dynamic and ludic way about the different types of discrimination in the sports domain while improving their English language skills and acquire new competences in the target language. They will have the opportunity to practice their oral and written expression and comprehension through diverse activities. The preceding will give them the tools to participate in the final task, a debate, and a form of a trial at the end of this sequence.
We chose this scenario because our subject is interesting, important, relevant, but also serious and realistic. Therefore, it took us time to define and consider how to present it to the students in a ludic and dynamic way. As a team, we decided to create a sequence inspired by the game Clue, in which the students are immersed in a situation where the soccer stadium of Alabama's university has been subjected to vandalization. During this game, the students play detectives who have to discover who did it. They investigate the suspect's files to understand their possible reasons for vandalizing the stadium. And after doing so, they have to choose a suspect and take them to trial to either defend or accuse them. And to make sure that they successfully accomplish their mission, they will be trained through ludic activities and exercises.
The request of our referent teacher was to conduct a debate at the end of the sequence. We have contemplated different objectives to achieve this final task. This sequence has as a principal pragmatic objective to help students formulate arguments by using modal verbs. Its principal pragmatic objective is for students to learn to manage interaction with others. As for our communicative objectives, at the end of this sequence, the students will be able to participate effectively in a conversation. They will understand the main points of the articles, and they will write their ideas and transform them into arguments that will be useful for the trial. Even though this sequence has principal objectives, through the activities, we also stimulate transversally other competences and objectives. We have chosen these linguistic points because they will support the achievement of the final task, the debate. We consider that by creating a sequence that contemplates the preceding objectives, the students will improve their language skills and be able to participate effectively in the debate.
Throughout the creation of our sequence, we relied on several linguistic materials to figure out exactly which skills to target and to be able to create suitable content for the students. So here is the list of the linguistic sources we've used. We have, for example, the European Framework Level Chart, the British Council book, second edition. We also use the Essential Grammar in Use, and finally the Cambridge Learner's Dictionary that we introduced to the students in case they had any difficulties with certain words.
Regarding the digital tools that we use to create our activities, we chose to work with several platforms such as Genially, Powtoon, WordWolfy, and others to ensure the diversity of the activities, and also because each of these tools was useful for us to accomplish a certain task. We had prepared a descriptive document for each digital tool used in our project. This document lists the tools and their functionalities, as well as their uses in each activity. It is available on Moodle. Regarding the Moodle functionalities that we have used in our project, we can go to the bottom left of this page to find links to the features that we have used. One of the features is dictionaries, where students can click here to find dictionaries to help them explain any word they didn't understand. As other functionalities, we use chat, choices, feedback, forum, and collaborative glossary. The chat feature will allow students to ask questions to their teacher in order to assist them throughout the activities, and they can also communicate with each other. We used the choices functionality in the form of multiple choice questions. This functionality will be approached by the students before starting our activity. They must answer the question, who did it? This will allow us to have their opinion on who really committed the act of vandalization well before officially choosing a culprit. We also used the forum where we asked them a question regarding the documents placed in their position to ensure that they had read and understood the articles to be read. They must answer this question, write their answers here, and submit it. As another feature of Moodle, we used the collaborative glossary. As the name suggests, the purpose of using this feature is to encourage students to work collaboratively to build a glossary containing a vocabulary list.
Our sequence is divided in three stages: engage, study, and activate. This is the second session that aims to help the students focus on specific linguistic points that will prepare them for the final task. During this session, they will be able to study and review grammar points while training their language skills. It will help students to remember what question words are. They have to match it with their usage. For example, you use this question word to ask about a way, a manner, or a form. Then students have to fly the airplane to the answer. Finish this activity, we consider that they are now ready to make questions for the trial. We ask them to think about the suspect and the questions that they would like to ask during the trial. Students have to do language work. We have created a video that will help them identify useful sentences when interacting with others. After they finish watching the video, they have the opportunity to classify these sentences by their usage. Done with these activities, they can move on to the third part, which is the pronunciation part. They have to watch a video to identify the U sound and the movement of the lips, the position of the lips. Then they have the opportunity to listen to other words and identify or not the U sound. And to finish, they have the opportunity to practice this pronunciation by recording themselves and making sure that they are pronouncing correctly. They will now prepare the arguments that they are going to use during the trial. We start by doing a review of modal verbs. Prepared a memory game for the students, and what they have to do is to try and match the modal verb with their usage. Activity, students can move on to the next part, which is spinning the wheel. They have to get three different modal verbs to prepare the arguments that they would like to use during the trial. Once they have the modal verbs, they can move on to the next part, which is creating the arguments that they would like to use. They once again have to record themselves. We wanted to make sure that they were training for the final task.
As far as difficulties are concerned, we've encountered several of them while working on our project. And the main one was the limited copyright-free support documents that we needed to highlight the theme of our subject and to create our activities. And therefore, we had to create our own original support documents that are here, for example, in a form of fake tweets that we've put together, which helped us create activities for the sequence. And also, they will be used as evidence during the trial or the final task against our suspects or fictional characters.
And last but not least, we have learned a lot of things during this project. One of them is how to make a serious and sensitive subject like ours more fun and easier to approach. And also how to use all the skills we've acquired in class to gamify activities and give the students new ways to learn. Thank you for your attention.